Hey folks, it's Jess Nipper. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with my reading journal and my February 2021 setup. I now have my journal in this little plastic wallet with all this glitter. I got this in the Archer and Olive subscription box in the first one, so I thought as I'm using a white journal it might help to keep it nice and clean. I apologize if there's any background noise because I am in my front room and we do back onto a main road, so if there is any traffic going past I apologize. Let's just get on with it. Today I am setting up for February 2021 and this is largely inspired but also at points is a copy of Amanda Rachley's February 2018 setup. I just want to get that out of the way now. And it's this hearts on a string theme and I really really liked it when I saw it for the first time back in 2018 and I've been thinking about recreating it since. But it's really simple, it's just red, white and black colour scheme. I only used like two or three pens to create this, a couple of blacks, my white Posca pen and this pinky reddy Crayola super tip. It's more, I'd say, on the like salmony end of the spectrum. I'm not sure, I don't know, I don't do like art and colour and stuff. You can make your own decision. But I started off using my Tombow Food Nosuke to colour in the black hearts, but that was running out of ink a little bit, so I switched to a thicker Faber-Castell 1.5. But for the titling, I decided to stick with my Tombow Food Nosuke because I like the streakiness that came with the ink running out in that pen, so I did my title like that. And then we're on to the inspired spreads. So the title page was a complete copy of her title, and the rest are set up for me inspired by Amanda's theme. So this is my to be read spread. It is very very full now because as you will see when my TBR video for February comes out, I have a lot of books on my TBR. But this is just a really really simple spread with hearts to denote the titles of each book and hanging hearts for the title, and along the bottom I've got like these strings of hearts, so they kind of look like fairy lights, I'd say, down at the bottom. And yeah, I'm really pleased with how that spread turned out. It's nice and simple. With my reading journal, I tend to go a little bit simpler at the moment. I want to maybe do some scrapbooking style spreads this month for books I've read, as well as my notes pages. So we will see how that goes. I will be posting to my bullet journal Insta and my Bookster Insta. So make sure you're following both of those. They're linked in the description. This next double page spread though is my reading tracker and my reading progress. So I've got these little mini months at a glance and I can fill in a little square for when I've read a physical book, listened to an audiobook or read an ebook. And I've got like a little hanging heart doodle coming down from that. But then I have this really big month at a glance running across the two page spread. And I thought I'd do this month because then in each day I'm going to write down exactly what I've read, what pages, the amount of pages that I've read sort of thing. So I can see what I'm reading when a little bit clearer because I like me some statistics. Got some more hanging hearts at the top between the two titles, and then what I'm going to do on the right hand spread is write down the name of the book that I'm reading. So the first book I have written down here is Stoner by John Williams, which is a novel bunch pick for February. Zoe picked that, so I'm really excited to get into that. And then I've got like a little progress bar in 50 page increments up to the total pages of the book, and I will colour in a box when I've read 50 pages. But now we're on to my books completed and notes spread. These tend to be quite empty until I am actually using them. So books completed, I'll just write down the book, the title, the dates I read it and the rating that I gave it. And notes is just for when I'm sat down reading and I want to make a note of something, be it a quote, a page, an event that takes place, my thoughts, where I think the plot is going to go, that sort of thing. And since I've started using this spread, I've actually put in a words I like little section, which is inspired by Caitlin De Silva. You should go and check out her channel and I will leave that in the description below when she set up her reading journal. But here is my final flip through. I'm so pleased with how it turned out. It's really simple. If you like this video, please remember to go and subscribe and hit that like button and also hit that notification bell so you get notified when I next upload a new video. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.